Hi students, good afternoon. Welcome to this video session. My name is Samuel Dominic Chukwu Emeka, aka Sam Dom for Peace. In this video session, we shall discuss the hypothesis testing about the population proportion. Please, it is highly recommended that you read your textbook, the sections in your textbook, read the notes, my notes on hypothesis testing, and read the prerequisite notes and view the prerequisite videos prior to viewing this video. It is important that you know the prerequisites. In this video, we are going to use technology. We are going to use my calculators as well as the Pearson StatCrunch. So we are going to be doing the Section 8.3 homework. Question 1. In a Harris poll, adults were asked if they are in favor of abolishing the penny. Among the responses, 1243 answered no, 486 answered yes, and 351 had no opinion. What is the sample proportion of yes responses, and what notation is used to represent it? So, of course, the sample proportion is p hat, and when you go to, I'm just gonna open up my site here. It is important as you do this to have the notes. It's important to have the notes because you might be referring to the notes. You might refer to it often. So I'm gonna go to mathematics, statistics, and in these notes, I will open a hypothesis testing and the hypothesis testing formulas. So if you look at the formulas for hypothesis testing, you will see all the symbols and the meaning, what they all represent. You see that p hat 1 is the first sample proportion. P hat is the sample proportion. While p hat is the sample proportion, p is the population proportion. So if you have p hat 1 is the first sample proportion. So this is important that you have all these, that you know all these, and you can always frequent it as necessary. For question 1, I'm just gonna pull up the calculator here. Usually you have it in standard, but I like using the scientific. So to get the sample proportion, let's find the sample size. The sample size will be 1243 plus 486 plus 351, and that gives us 2080. I'm gonna put this in memory. 2080. And they want us to find the sample proportion of the yes responses. So the yes responses is 486. So 486 divided by our recall memory equal to. So the sample proportion of the yes responses is 0.234. So the answer is D. Question 2. A certain drug is used to treat asthma. In a clinical trial of the drug, 30 of 285 treated subjects experienced headaches based on data from the manufacturer. The accompanying calculator display shows results. Let me make this bigger, a little bit bigger. The accompanying calculator display shows results from a test of the claim that less than 10% of treated subjects experienced headaches. Use the normal distribution as an approximation to the binomial distribution and assume a 0.01 significance level, that's 1% level of significance, to complete parts A through E below. So as you can see here, this is the result from the hypothesis test. As you can see, this is the left-tailed, okay, is the left-tailed test because of the less than, the population proportion is less than 0.1, so it's left-tailed. The test statistic, which is the Z, is 0.30, so two decimal places will be 0.30. The p-value to four decimal places is 0.6165. The null hypothesis is that the population proportion is equal to 0.1. That's the null. From this, we're asked whether to reject the null, decide whether to reject the null. So I'm going to come here, back here on the hypothesis, formulas for hypothesis testing. And, you know, later on you can look at this, but I want to say something here. Because here, from this question, you can see they gave us the p-value and the test statistic. So you can still use both methods. You can still use the classical approach and the p-value approach. However, the options here is the p-value approach. That's the options here, the p-value approach. If you read these options, you will notice that they are using the p-value approach. And with the p-value approach, anytime they, if we go here to p-value approach for population proportion, hypothesis test about a population proportion. If you go here to the approaches, we keep scrolling down to find. Yeah, this is the critical value or the classical approach. You can still use this because you have the test statistic. However, the options here are for the p-value. So you look for the p-value approach, and you will see that anytime the p-value is less than or equal to the level of significance, you reject the null. Anytime the p-value is less than or equal to level of significance, reject the null. And when you reject the null, that means there is sufficient evidence to support the claim of the alternative hypothesis. And you can later read this for the interpretation. So if you come here, the p-value we have is 0.6165. The level of significance, alpha, is 0.01. So 0.62. I mean, if we convert it to two decimal places, it's greater than the p-value is greater than 0.01. 0.62 is greater than 0.01. So, and if it's greater than that, then you do not reject the null. Do not reject the null. Okay, your textbook says fail to reject the null. That's fine. You can say that. But we do not reject the null. It's the same thing. You do not reject the null hypothesis. Fail to reject the null hypothesis, it means the same thing. And when you do not reject the null, that means you're saying that there is insufficient evidence to to support the alternative hypothesis. So the alternative hypothesis is that the population proportion is less than 0.1. That is the alternative hypothesis. So we fail to reject the null because the p-value is greater than the level of significance. Yeah, but later on, when we do more problems here, we will interpret these. Because when you do not reject the null, that means there is insufficient evidence to support the alternative hypothesis. So we'll say fail to reject the null because the p-value is greater than the significance level. And this is what we call the p-value approach. The final conclusion is that there is insufficient evidence to support the claim of the alternative hypothesis. So there is not sufficient evidence to support that claim that the population proportion is less than 0.1, which is 10%. So when you read the options A and D, you eliminate A and D, because when you do not reject the null hypothesis, that means there is insufficient evidence. So we look at B and C, and you look at B and C, you see that B says there is not sufficient evidence to support the claim that less than 10% of treated subjects experience headaches. C says there is not sufficient evidence to warrant rejection of the claim that less than 10% of treated subjects experience headaches. Remember what I said here, to support the claim of the alternative hypothesis. So you now use just B, okay? Some people might say, what about C? But the wording is important. The wording is very, very important, okay? The wording is very important because you have to pay clear attention to the wording. Question 3. A survey of 1,578 randomly selected adults showed that 513 of them have heard of a new electronic reader. The accompanying technology display results from a test of the claim that 35% of adults have heard of the new electronic reader. Use the normal distribution as an approximation to the binomial distribution and assume a 1%, which is 0.01, significance level to complete parts A through E. As you can see here, the critical Z is plus or minus 2.5758. Okay, that's the critical Z. And that tells you right away that is a two-tailed test. It tells you right away that is a two-tailed test. So this is a two-tailed test. The test statistic is to two decimal places is negative 2.07. The p-value is 0.0381. The null will be equal to, null is always equal to, okay, equality. The null is equal to, if you read these options, it's still based on p-value. It's still based on p-value. So the p-value approach is still based on p-value approach. Anytime you're using p-value approach. Now, this is for left tail test. This is for right tail test. Then you now have for two tail tests. For two tail tests. So, for two tail tests, you see the wording. You see the wording, sufficient evidence to warrant the rejection of the null. And here, insufficient evidence to warrant the rejection of the null. So you look at just the wordings here. The p-value is 0.0381 and the significance level is 0.01. So the p-value is greater than the significance level. So if it's greater, you fail to reject the null. You do not reject the null because the p-value is greater. So that is C. And then the conclusion is you look at the wording. You look at the wording when you fail to reject the null. Do not reject the null. There is insufficient evidence to warrant the rejection of the null. So you look at options B and D. There is not sufficient evidence to support the claim that 35% of adults have heard of the new electronic reader. D, there is not sufficient evidence to warrant rejection of the claim. Do you see that now? To warrant rejection of the claim that 35% of adults have heard of the new electronic reader. So you go with D. Remember, I said look at the wording. Okay. Question 4. A genetic experiment involving peas yielded one sample of offspring consisting of 408 green peas and 128 yellow peas. Use a 0.01 significance level to test the claim that under the same circumstances, 26% of offspring peas will be yellow. Identify the null hypothesis, alternative hypothesis, test statistic, p-value, conclusion about the null hypothesis, and final conclusion that addresses the original claim. Use the p-value method and the normal distribution as an approximation to the binomial distribution. So this is what we are going to do. I will start with StatCrunch, and then I will use my calculator the next one. Okay. So this is what you are going to do. This is hypothesis testing about a population proportion. So we are just doing population proportion, one sample. That's what we are doing. We are dealing with one samples here. So this is what we're going to do. Go to question help, go to StatCrunch. And I'm going to make this to be on the same page so you can see it. All right. We are testing hypothesis test that 26% of offspring peas will be yellow. So of course, when you look at this first, the null hypothesis is always equal to. So p is equal to 0.26. So we look at C, D, and E. C is left-tailed, D is right-tailed, E is two-tailed. So our options we will consider are C, D, and E because the population proportion is 26%, which is 0.26. Okay, now we want to see if is it left-tailed or right-tailed or two-tailed. We look at the original the original claim gave us the one sample and the peas. Then it says use a 0.01 significance level to test the claim that under the same circumstances, 26% of offspring peas will be yellow. It didn't say less than 26%. If it says less than 26%, then we will look at it as left-tailed. If it says greater than 26%, we will look at it at right-tailed. If it didn't tell us less than or greater than, or less than or more than, then we look at it at two-tailed. Okay? So we will practice more of this so you can really understand it. But this is two-tailed. Now, to find the test statistic, I'm going to use StatCrunch. You go to stats. You go to proportion stats. Proportion stats. We're looking at one sample with summary, because this is with summary. Not now, if it's with data, that means they gave you the data, actually the raw data. They gave you the raw data. But here they didn't give us the raw data. They gave us the summary of the experiment. So you go to, let me repeat it again, stats, proportion stats, one sample with summary. Number of successes, in this case, they said 26% of offspring peas will be yellow. So our success is getting yellow peas. That is the success. Is getting yellow peas. This 26% is not the number, it's the population proportion. But the sample, in the sample, the number of successes is X over N, is the X, while N is the number of observations. So the sample proportion is X over N. Here, however, the number of successes is our yellow peas because of what we are testing, that the 26% of offspring peas will be yellow. So the number of successes is how many yellow peas did we get from the experiment? And that is 128. Now, what is the total number of observations? The total number of observations, in this case, is the total number of peas, both the green peas and yellow peas. So that would be 408 plus 128. And that gives us 536. So we come here, we write 536. And you're looking at perform hypothesis test. The P for the null hypothesis, our P is equal to 0.26. That's the 26%. And the alternative hypothesis, this is a two-tailed, okay? If it was left-tailed, you select less than. If it was right-tailed, you select a greater than. But this is a two-tailed, okay? So you do this, you leave it like this, and you click compute. So we click compute, and this is our result here. The test statistic is negative, so two decimal places will be negative 1.12. The p-value is 0.2633. The conclusion, the p-value is, they want us to use p-value method. Use the p-value method. So the conclusion here, we look at the p-value and the level of significance. This is 0.2633 is greater than 0.01 significance level. So fail to reject the null because the p-value is greater than the significance level. So that is A. Now, what's the final conclusion? The final conclusion for two-tailed test. When you fail to reject the null, then there is not sufficient evidence to warrant the rejection of the null. So there is not sufficient evidence to warrant rejection of the null. There is nothing like support the claim, no, for two-tailed test. So there is not sufficient evidence to warrant rejection of the claim that 26% of offspring peas will be yellow. That is for two-tailed test. If you do not reject the null, so the answer here will be B. Okay? Question 5. just going to go ahead and close this. In a recent poll of 755 randomly selected adults, 588 said that it is morally wrong to not report all income on tax returns. Use a 0.01 significance level to test the claim that 75% of adults say that it is morally wrong to not report all income on tax returns. And then identify the null hypothesis, alternative hypothesis, test statistic, p-value, conclusion about the null hypothesis, and the final conclusion that addresses the original claim. Use the p-value method. Use the normal distribution as an approximation of the binomial distribution. Okay, folks, we've been using the p-value method, but I also want you to learn the classical method or the critical value method. Some textbooks will say traditional approach or traditional method. Some will say classical approach or classical method. Some will say critical value approach or critical value method. I expect you to know both methods, both of them. And with my calculator, I used both of them. So watch me do it now with my calculator. So I'm gonna go here and pull up my calculator. You can just go to portfolio and go to hypothesis testing calculator. So this is what I'm gonna use to do this. If we look at this question here, it says to test the claim that 75% of adults say that it's morally wrong. So this is also a two-tailed test, okay? P is 0.75, which is the null hypothesis, and the alternative hypothesis will be that P is not equal to 0.75. So that would be F here. Okay, so I'm gonna bring this up here. I know it's like, look at the way this is now. Okay, I will shuttle back and forth. I think it will be better that way to shuttle back and forth so this wouldn't look weird. Okay, so I'm gonna go to population proportion, one sample, two-tailed. Okay, one sample, two-tailed. And you keep scrolling, like you look at the headings. Oh, there you go. This is the first one. Yeah, we also have what we call the confidence interval method. That's right. So we have three methods. If you have two tails, if it's a two-tailed test, you can actually do it with three methods. I'm going to do it with the three methods. Okay, I'll do it with the three methods. So you say it. The question, the significance level is 0.01. So I put 0.01. You come here, you select decimal. If you put one, you can select percent. The X, number of individuals, is 588, and the N is 755. So I have 588, I have 755. Population proportion is 0.75, which is 75%. So we can just put 75, we come here, we put percent. Then click calculate. Now look at it here. See the classical approach, the reason, the decision do not reject the null hypothesis. What's the reason? That the critical value is not in the critical region. The critical Z value is not in the critical region. And this is the p-value approach. Okay, p-value is greater than the significance level. Because of that, do not reject the null. So you see, gives you the same decision. The same decision, both approaches gives you the same decision. And of course, the conclusion, there is insufficient evidence to warrant the rejection of the null. Now, bring this to, this is classical approach, p-value approach. Bring this to confidence interval method. Confidence interval method, we have to put the confidence level. In this case, it's 99%. Confidence level is 99%. Put 99, select percent. Number of individuals is still 588. Sample size is 755. Population proportion is 75%. Calculate. The test statistic is 1.83. That's this year. 1.83. P-value is this year, p-value 0.0675. So, do not reject, which is fail to reject the null. There is not sufficient evidence. Okay. And I'm just going to be using my calculator. So, you know, I will just be, because it will save time. Because with my calculator, I also give the decision and the conclusion. And I actually want to make sure, why I like using my calculator also, is to make sure that that the calculations are done well, and that both decisions are the right thing. You know, that both decisions are the same. So once you finish using it, you can just, you can reset, or you just refresh the whole thing. Okay. Question 6. In 1997, a survey of 980 households showed that 148 of them use email. Use those sample results to test the claim that more than 15% of households use email. So this is a right-tail test. Use a 0.05 significance level. So more than 15%. So the null will be that P is equal to 15%, which is 0.15. And the alternative hypothesis is that P is greater than 0.15. And that is this here. Test statistic. I'm going to come here, one sample, right-tailed. And you just scroll down to test hypothesis using classical approach and p-value approach. So population proportion is 15%. Number of individuals is 148. Sample size is 980. Level of significance is 0.05. Get decimal here. Calculate. So as you can see, they still give you the same decision. Both methods, both approaches or methods gives you the same decision. And of course now the same conclusion. So the test statistic is 0.09 to two decimal places. 0.09. The p-value is 0.4644 to four decimal places. 0.4644. Oh, I'm sorry. They said three decimal places. Hey. Okay, folks, you see that now? They say three decimal places. I mean, we've been doing four decimal places, right? We've been doing that. Now they say three decimal places. So it will be 0.464. So please watch out, okay? 0.464. Okay, what is the conclusion? I got it here, okay? Conclusion, there is insufficient evidence to support the claim of the alternative hypothesis. So as you can see, there is not sufficient evidence, yes. So that's it. Now, is the conclusion valid today? Why or why not? So with this one, if this was the email they used in 1997, can you imagine? 1997, right? And they're asking us, is the conclusion valid today? Come on. So I wouldn't say the conclusion is valid today. No, the conclusion is not valid today because the population characteristics of the use of email are changing rapidly. So this like, you know, this like kind of question you answer based on like sense thinking. Like it's not really much technical to it. It's just question you just answer based on, okay, no, it shouldn't be valid today. I mean, this is 1997. And now it's 2018. So, question 7. In a recent poll, let me just refresh this. In a recent poll, 784 adults were asked to identify their favorite seats when they fly. And 511 of them chose a window seat. Use a 0.05, which is 5% significance level, to test the claim that the majority of adults prefer window seats when they fly. Identify all those stuff, okay? You can read up the whole thing here. You can now read it up. Okay, so use a 0.05 significance level to test the claim that the majority of adults prefer window seats when they fly. Majority. As you can see here, majority is at least 51%. Anytime you say majority, it means at least 51%. Now, 50% is, you know, the center. But majority is, it's more than 50%, I mean. I'm sorry, I wouldn't say at least 51%. But majority means more than 50%. That's majority. More than 50%. Okay? Not at least 51%, but more than 50%. So, that is majority. I said 51% probably because of elections. Okay. You know, with elections, you can use decimals on people, right? You can use decimals. The votes are people. So you can use decimals on people. So that's why I said majority win. Majority win is at least 51%. But here is adults though. Yeah. But majority is more than 50%, okay? Just know that. So this is a right tail test. It's a right tail test. So the correct option will be this here. The null is 0.5 and the alternative hypothesis is more than 50%. Yeah, majority. Test statistic. I'm just going to use my calculator, okay? Population proportion in this case is 50%. Number of individuals is 511. And then the sample size is 784. So 511, 784. Level of significance is 0.05 in decimal. Calculate. So as you can see here, it's the same decision with both approaches. Critical Z value, test statistic is 8.5. I know they say round to two decimal places as needed. You can just write 8.5, that's fine. Because that is the meaning of as needed. As needed, OK? Okay. As needed means if it is two, if it is more than two decimal places, then round to two decimal places. Then if it is less than two decimal places, you can just write it as is. P-value, as we see here, is zero. If you want to write 0.0, 0.00, 0.000, that's fine. Or you can just write zero because it's as needed. As needed. So we have to reject the null. They want us to use the p-value method. Okay. Like I said, I want you to know both methods, both the classical and the p-value. So reject the null with the p-value method. You reject the null because the p-value is less than or equal to the significance level. So that is B here. And the final conclusion is that there is sufficient evidence to support the claim of the alternative hypothesis. The claim of the alternative hypothesis is the greater than, is the majority. This is the claim. Okay, of the alternative hypothesis. So there is sufficient evidence to support the claim that the majority of adults prefer window seats when they fly. Question 8. Let me refresh this. A clinical trial was conducted using a new method designed to increase the probability of conceiving a girl. As of this writing, 937 babies were born to parents using the new method, and 875 of them were girls. Use a 5% significance level to test the claim that the new method is effective in increasing the likelihood that a baby will be a girl. And then identify the null, alternative, and the rest of them. So, this here, it says use a 5% significance level to test the claim that the new method is effective in increasing the likelihood that the baby will be a girl. So, you look for some words more than majority. Increasing, okay, that points to right tail test. Now, if they say is effective for 20%, you know, if they don't use some vocabulary words that denotes less than or greater than, then you know that it's two-tailed. But in this case, it's a right tail test because of this, in increasing. The one we just did was majority, okay? Now, this one says in increasing the likelihood, which is the probability that a baby will be a girl. All right, so the null will be, the null is that P is equal to 0.5, which is 50%, and the alternative will be that the P is greater than 50%. So it's still right tail test. Test statistic. If you guys want, we can use StatCrunch. If you want, we can. Or we can just use my calculator since it gives the decision and conclusion. So here, the population, the only thing is make sure that you select the actual type of test. Okay, because if you pick left-tailed or two-tailed, then it will give you wrong answer. And the same thing with StatCrunch. You know, with StatCrunch, you have to select the proper thing also. Let's do this one with StatCrunch, okay? And then the next ones, we'll just use my calculator. StatCrunch, you have to pick the correct thing, okay? StatCrunch. Remember, you go to stats, proportion stats, one sample with summary. So here, the success is 875. This 875, Number of observations is 937. Now, look at what I'm saying here. This is two-tailed by default. You have to make sure you select right-tailed. Make sure. And in this case, I know it's 50%, but if it's not 50%, you change it. Okay? So make sure. Compute. So we have the test statistic is 26.56. P-value, as you can see here, folks, here, p-value, look at the way they wrote it. Less than 0.0001. It just tells you that the p-value is zero. That's what it means. Okay? Just write zero. That is what it means. P-value is less than the significance level. So you reject the null. Okay? Reject the null. P-value is less than or equal to the significance level. Our final conclusion is that when you reject the null, that means there is sufficient evidence to support the claim that the new method is effective in increasing the likelihood that a baby will be a girl. There is sufficient evidence to support that claim. So is D. Question 9. A clinical trial was conducted using a new method designed to increase the probability of conceiving a boy, in this case a boy. As of this writing, 282 babies were born to parents using the new method, and 247 of them were boys. Use a 5% significance level to test the claim that the new method is effective in increasing the likelihood that a baby will be a boy. So this is still a right tail test. So this will be our test, not an alternative. Test statistic. I'm gonna use mine this time. So one sample right tailed, population proportion is 50%. Number of individuals, 282. And, well, 282 is the sample size, while 247 is the number of individuals. So, 247 number of individuals, 282 sample size. And 5% significance level, or 0.05 in decimal. Calculate. So the same thing, we still reject the null. Test statistic is 12.62. P-value is 0. We reject the null. And there is sufficient evidence to support the claim of the alternative hypothesis. So reject the null because the p-value is less than or equal to significance level. There is sufficient evidence to support the claim of the alternative hypothesis. Question 10. In a study of pregnant women and the ability to correctly predict the sex of their baby, 57 of the pregnant women had 12 years of education or less, and 40.4% of these women correctly predicted the sex of their baby. Use a 5% significance level to test the claim that these women have an ability to predict the sex of their baby, equivalent to random guesses. So, as you can see here, to test the claim that the women have an ability, it didn't say more women, it didn't say less women, it didn't use any vocabulary words increase or decrease. It did not use those. Okay, so you now find out that this is a two-tailed test. Okay, you find out that it is a two-tailed test. So in this case, you read the question again. This here that says 40.4% of these women correctly predicted the sex of their baby. They said 57 of the pregnant women had 12 years of education or less, and 40.4% of these women correctly predicted the sex of their baby. So 40.4% of the 57 is the number of individuals, is the X. The X is 40.4% of the 57. The population here is still 50%. It's still 50%. This 40.4% is of the 57. So it's a sample proportion. It is not a population proportion. It's a sample proportion. Okay, it's not population proportion. The population proportion is still 50%, which is 0.5. And this is a two-tailed test, okay, because there is nothing here that says increase, decrease, more than, less than. So our correct option would now be E in this case. Test statistic, I'm just going to... Now, for this one, you just have to be a little careful. Just a little careful. One sample, two-tailed. And I'm going to use both approaches. So the significance level is 0.05 in decimal, okay, or 5 in percent. Number of individuals here, folks. This is 40.4% of these women. So the number of individuals will be, of course, 40.4 divided by 100. 40.4 divided by 100 is 0.404. So of the women, of the 57 times 57. So this is I'm going to use 23. I'm just going to use 23. Okay, this is based on women. So I'm going to use 23. I know some people would argue, well, you can have 0.028 women. So anytime you have something like that, why don't you just round to 24? And those that argue that way, they make perfect sense. Okay, you can have 23.028 women. Once it crosses over, it has to be 24. However, I'm going to use 23 because, you know, just for you to get this right, okay? Just round. But honestly, when you are dealing with human beings, even if you have 23.001, you okay, it has to be 24 human beings. Yeah, you can't be having decimals in human beings. So just for you to get this right, I'm going to use 23 as the X. So I'm going to put 23 here. And the sample size is 57. Population proportion is 50%. Enter. So you see, they gave us the same decision. Do not reject the null. Both approaches gives us the same decision. If you ever do something and you see that the two decisions are not the same for both approaches, then there's a problem. There is a problem. is either your question was not written well, or it's my fault. Either way, okay. But both approaches must give you the same thing. Yeah. But don't make up your own questions, because these questions has already been done. Because if you make up your own questions, then you might see those. That means it's wrong. So we have why we follow some questions, okay? We have why we follow a specific kind of question. So don't come and tell me, hey, Mr. C, I put this, I tried it with different numbers and it gave me two different decisions. The first thing I'll ask you is, where did you get the question from? Did you make it on your own? So, please, my calculator works. It does. It works. But if you notice anything and you got your question from an accurate source, just let me know, okay? Just let me know so I can look at it again and see. You know, I'll solve it manually, look at it again and see, hey, whether it's my fault or your fault. So the test statistic is -1.46. -1.46. P-value to four decimal places is 0.1451. Conclusion, do not reject the null. Fail to reject the null. And why? Once you say that is insufficient evidence to warrant the rejection of the null. There is insufficient, there is not sufficient evidence, okay? To warrant the rejection of the null. And that rejection of the null suggests that there is not sufficient evidence to warrant rejection of the claim that these women have an ability to predict the sex of their baby, equivalent to random guesses. The results for these women with 12 years of education or less suggest that their percentage of correct predictions is not very different from results expected with random guesses. Okay. Question 11. When testing gas pumps for accuracy, fuel quality enforcement specialists tested pumps and found that 1,297 of them were not pumping accurately within 3.3 ounces when 5 gallons is pumped, and 5,679 pumps were accurate. Use a 1% significance level to test the claim of an industry representative that less than 20% of the pumps are inaccurate. That less than 20% of the pumps are inaccurate. Okay? So, this will be a left tail test. Left tail test. P is 0.2 as the null hypothesis. Alternative hypothesis is that P is less than 0.2. Test statistic. I'm going to come here. One sample, left-tailed. Population proportion is 20%. Number of individuals. In this case, inaccurate is 5679. 5679 pumps were inaccurate because they want us to test for inaccurate. So this is 5679. Sample size would be the whole sample, both the accurate ones and the inaccurate ones. Oh, wait a minute, I'm sorry. See, 5679 were accurate. Okay, 1297 were inaccurate. So this is 1297. Now the sample size will be both the accurate and the ones that the pumps the accu- the one the pumps that were accurate and the pumps that were inaccurate. So clear this. This will be 1297 plus 5679. 1297 are the pumps that were inaccurate, and 5679 are the pumps that are accurate. So you want to find the total, the sample size is the total number of pumps. You add those, and that gives you 6976. 6976. Level of significance is 0.01 in decimal. Calculate. Want to make sure this is left-tailed. Okay, want to make sure it's left-tailed. Okay, so test statistic is -2.94. -2.94. P value is 0.24 decimal places, 0.0016. So because the p value is less than the significance level, you reject the null. Okay. You reject the null. There is sufficient evidence to support the claim that less than 20% of the pumps are inaccurate. Question 12. Question 12. In a study of 420,119 cell phone users, 111 subjects developed cancer of the brain or nervous system. Test the claim of a somewhat common belief that such cancers are affected by cell phone use. That is, test the claim that cell phone users develop cancer of the brain or nervous system at a rate that is different. That is different from the rate of 0.0340% for people who do not use cell phones. Because this issue has such great importance, use a 0.001 significance level. Identify the null hypothesis and the rest of them. So that is different. So this means that this is a two-tailed test, okay? That is different. So this would be C here. Test statistic. We're gonna use one sample, two-tailed. Significance level here is 0.001. In decimal, number of individuals is 111. Sample size is 420119. Population proportion is 0.0340%. 0.034%. Test statistic is -2.66. -2.66. P value is 0.0077. Do not reject the null hypothesis. The p-value is greater than the significance level. So fail to reject the null hypothesis because the p-value is greater than the significance level. final conclusion, there is insufficient evidence to warrant the rejection of the null hypothesis. There is not sufficient evidence to warrant the rejection of the null. Now, there is not sufficient evidence to warrant rejection of the claim that cell phone users develop cancer of the brain or nervous system at a rate that is different from the rate of this. So, if you look at this question, there is insufficient evidence to warrant the rejection of the null. However, a rate that is different is the hypothesis. So, you can also say, let's look at the other not sufficient evidence. There is not sufficient evidence to support the claim that cell phone users develop cancer of the brain or nervous system at a rate that is different. Okay? So you look at B and D. Of course, from what we've been doing, if you check D, this particular question is a little bit tricky. In the final conclusion, if you look at the conclusion, there is insufficient evidence to warrant the rejection of the null hypothesis. However, if you read this, this is not the null. This is the alternative. Alternative is that it is different. Alternative is that it's different, not equal to. So you now look at the other part, not sufficient evidence to support this, the alternative. This is the alternative. So you can say this, okay, folks, let's learn something here. You can say there is insufficient evidence to warrant the rejection of the null. Or you can also say there is insufficient evidence to support the claim of the alternative. You cannot say that. You cannot say that in that question, in this particular question. Okay, as you can see, I've done it before. So I'm gonna go with B. Okay. Question 13. In a survey of 145 senior executives, 52.4% said that the most common job mistake. 52.4% said that the most common job interview mistake is to have little or no knowledge of the company. Use a 5% significance level to test the claim that in the population of all senior executives, 45% say that the most common job interview mistake is to have little or no knowledge of the company. Identify the null hypothesis and the rest of them. So, as you can see here, it says 45% of use this to test that. 45% say that this is to have little or no knowledge. There is nothing here that tells us increase of, decrease of, no, or less than, more than. So, this is a two-tailed test, okay? And we're going to use this here, 45%, because that's the population proportion. It says population of all senior executives. Use a 5% significance level to test the claim that in the population of all senior executives, 45% say that the most common job interview mistake is to have little or no knowledge of the company. So this is the population proportion here, 0.45. So this is it, and this is a two-tailed test. So this will be A here. Test statistic is one sample, two-tailed. Population proportion, use this right here. Significance level is 5%. You know, you cannot put 5% as well. I mean, you want to put 0.05, that's fine. Or you can put 5%. Will still give us the same answer. number of individuals, you see, well, they didn't give it to us, but that's fine because we can just get it right here. We can just get it. We'll do 52.4 divided by 100 is 0.524 times 145. And I'm just going to round this to 76. Okay, 76 individuals. So this is 76 number of individuals. Sample size 145. Population proportion is 45%. Calculate. So the test statistic is 1.79. P-value is 0.024 decimal places. 0.0727. Do not reject the null because the p-value is greater than the significance level. Fail to reject the null. There is insufficient evidence. Question 14. Trials in an experiment with a polygraph include 98 results that include 23 cases of wrong results and 75 cases of correct results. Use a 1% significance level to test the claim that such polygraph results are correct less than 80% of the time. Are correct less than 80% of the time. See that? Less than. So P is less than. The alternative is that P is less than 0.8. That's the alternative hypothesis. So this is a left tail test. Left tail test. Test statistic. I'm going to refresh this. One sample, left tailed. Population proportion is 80%. Number of individuals. We are testing the claim that the results are correct. Correct. So we're going to use the cases of correct result, 75 cases of correct results, because our own is testing it that is correct. So 75, and the number of trials, that's the sample size, is 98. And use a 1% significance level, or you can say 0.01. In decimal, calculate. So the test statistic is negative 0.86. The p-value is 0.1953. Do not reject the null because there is insufficient evidence to support the claim of the alternative hypothesis. Fail to reject the null. There is not sufficient evidence to support that claim. Question 15. A recent broadcast of a television show had a 15 share, meaning that among 6,000 monitored households with TV sets in use, 15% of them were tuned to this program. Use a 0.01 significance level to test the claim of an advertiser that among the households with TV sets in use, less than 20% were tuned into the program. identify the null hypothesis and the rest of them. So this is a left-tailed test. Test statistic. Let's refresh this. One sample left-tailed. Population proportion is 20%. Number of individuals, 15% of 6,000. Okay, 15% of 6,000, 0.15 times 6,000. You know what? I can probably put another. I can put another calculator here, whereby they just give you the sample proportion. How about it? Whereby they just give you the sample proportion rather than number of individuals. I probably will do that if I have time. Okay. Because I just want us, the way I design these calculators is for us to be able to like use only technology, only, and solve the whole thing. But that is after you have done it manually. You know, when you read the textbook and read my notes, then you do it manually. Then you can use calculator and just do it as well to verify your work. To verify your work. So 15% of 6,000 gives us 900. So this is 900. Sample size is 6,000. Level of significance is 0.01. Enter. Okay, the test statistic is -9.68. P-value is 2, is 0. Okay, so please look at this here. This actually means 2.22044604925013 times 10 exponent negative 16. So that means 0.00000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000 Okay, the same thing applies to professors. You see, they, when they say rate my professor, it's an online survey. Some of, in fact, some people who are not even happy with a particular person might claim to be their student and still give the rate my professor bad review. Or maybe it is possible that you did not even take the class. It's very possible. Or you took the class and you didn't finish. You know, and then they go to rate my professor and they rate the professor. All those results are biased. Very, very biased. You know, it's the same thing. I think American Idol in voting in American Idol and the rest of the shows, right? Which other ones do they have? The Voice, right? Where users vote, online polls, all those results are biased. They are not, we don't regard them as valid. Those are not valid results. They are not, we don't take those results seriously, no. Is that we don't at all, because those are biased. They are biased forms of sampling. So let's look at this and look at the conclusion, actually. So this question is really important, very, very important. I like this particular question. After you find out that the survey is an online survey in which the users choose whether to respond or not. Okie dokie. So now, this is a more than, this is a right tail test. Okay, and the P is 25%, 0.25, the population proportion. So this will be this here. Test statistic. So one sample, right-tailed, population proportion is 25% or 0.25 in decimal. A number of individuals, 25.7% of this, okay? So let's get that. 25.7% is 0.257, then times 61649, and that gives us 15,844. Sample size is 61649. Level of significance is 0.05. Enter. You see, reject the null. Reject the null. So test statistic is 4.02. P-value is 0.0000. So p-value is 0. The p-value is 0. Reject the null because there is sufficient evidence to support the claim. There is sufficient evidence to support that claim that more than 25% say that bosses scream at employees. But if the sample is a voluntary response sample, okay, voluntary response, the conclusion is not valid. It's not, it might not be valid. No, I said it, because it's convenience sampling or voluntary response sample is not valid. I know the question says might not be valid. Might not be valid, okay? It's not, I'm telling you, it's not. It's convenience sampling or voluntary response sample. Question 17. When 3,012 adults were surveyed in a poll, 79% say that they use the internet. Is it okay for a newspaper reporter to write that 75%, which is 75%, okay, that 75% of all adults use the internet? Why or why not? Identify the null hypothesis and the rest of them. Okay, remember, you have to know both methods, the classical approach and the p-value approach. Okay, both methods. All right, so it says here, is it okay to write that 3/4 of all adults use the internet? They didn't say more than, they didn't say less than, they just said 3/4. So which means that this is a two-tailed test. Okay, it's a two-tailed test. So this will be this, yeah, two-tailed. One sample, two-tailed. Significance level. So, as you can, if you read this question, they did not give us the significance level. They did not. They didn't give us the significance level. Right? They did not. If you go to the formulas here, I think I mentioned it somewhere. If the significance level is not given, use 5%. If significance level is not given, use 5%. I mentioned it somewhere. Yeah. Well, if the population proportion is not given, use 50%. And then if the level of significance is not given, use 5%. Yeah. If significance level is not given, use 5%. So I mentioned it here. Okay. So we're going to use 5%. And number of individuals, 79% of 3,012. So 0.79 times 3012. That is 2379. We're going to use 2379. Sample size is 3012. Population proportion is 75%. That is 3/4. Calculate. Test statistic is 5.05. P-value is 0. Reject the null. Okay. There is sufficient evidence to warrant rejection of the null hypothesis. So reject the null. There is. Question 18. We're getting there. In a recent court case, it was found that during a period of 11 years, 872 people were selected for grand jury duty, and 38% of them were from the same ethnicity. Among the people eligible for grand jury duty, 79.3% were of this ethnicity. Use a 0.01 significance level to test the claim that the selection process is biased against allowing this ethnicity to sit on the grand jury. Identify the null hypothesis and the rest of them. So I know here they said it's biased against allowing this ethnicity to sit on the grand jury. So I know some of you might say two-tailed test. However, let's review the question again. We want to test that the process is biased against allowing them to sit on the grand jury, which means that it's less than. Okay, we want to test the claim that less than this, that less than 0.793 actually sits on the jury. So I know it's the English there, okay? It's the English there. Some people might just go ahead and say it's a two-tailed test. Because nothing here says less than or more than, right? So you might say it's a two-tailed test. But if you read the question here, it's biased against allowing this ethnicity to sit on the grand jury. So I'm going to go with left-tailed here, left-tailed test. I'm going to go with left-tailed test. One sample left-tailed. One sample left-tailed. Population proportion is 79.3%. Number of individuals. Let's do 38% of 872. 0.38 times 872. I think I'm going to put another option. I will put an option whereby you don't need number of individuals. So we don't have to do this, you know, you just put 38%. But for now, let's just finish it with this. So the number of individuals will be 331. 331. Sample size is 872. Let me do this again. 0.38 times 872. Yeah, 331. Sample size 872. Level of significance is 0.01 decimal. Calculate. Test statistic is negative 30.13. P value is zero. Reject the null hypothesis. There is sufficient evidence to support the claim of the alternative hypothesis. Reject the null because the p value is less than or equal to the significance level. Does the jury selection system appear to be fair? It says here there is sufficient evidence to support the claim of the alternative hypothesis. Okay, the alternative hypothesis is that the population proportion is less than this. Okay. There is sufficient evidence to support the claim that the selection process is biased against allowing this ethnicity to sit on the grand jury. The jury selection process appears to be unfair. So that's the answer. Question 19. A recent sports game set a record for the number of television viewers. The game had a share of 77%, meaning that among the television sets in use at the time of the game, 77% were tuned to the game. The sample size is 25,556 households. Use a 5% significance level to test the claim that more than 74% of television sets in use were tuned to the sports game. Identify the null hypothesis and the rest of them. So this is a right-tailed test, more than. So what will it be? It will be this right here, right-tailed test. I come here, use one sample right-tailed. Population proportion is 74%. Number of individuals will do 77% of 25,556. So 0.77 times 25,556 equal to. So we use 19,678. 19,678. Sample size is 25,556. Level of significance is 5%, which is 0.05 in decimal. Calculate. Test statistic is 10.93. P-value is 0. Reject the null because the p-value is less than or equal to the significance level. There is sufficient evidence to support the claim of the alternative hypothesis. Question 20. In a simple random sample of 33 colored candies, it is found that none of them are blue. Use a 0.01 significance level to test the claim of the candy company that the proportion of candies that are blue is equal to 0.10. Can a hypothesis test for a claim about the population proportion be used? If so, test the claim. If not, explain why not. This particular question is a binomial distribution. It's a binomial distribution, and because of that, we cannot use the normal distribution for this hypothesis test on this data. So it's just the binomial distribution can be used for the hypothesis test on this data. Is a binomial distribution. The next question, we identify the null and the alternative. Remember they said use a 1% significance level to test the claim that the proportion that are blue is equal to 0.10. So this tells us it's not less than, it's not greater than. So this is a two-tailed test. It's two-tailed. Okay? It's two-tailed. Test statistic. We don't have a test statistic for binomial distribution. We don't have a test statistic. Find the p-value. Okay, so folks, you come here, you go to this one sample, two-tailed. The first one is test hypothesis using classical approach, p-value approach. Second one is test hypothesis using confidence interval method. Third one is test hypothesis using p-value approach, but that is of a binomial distribution. See that? Population proportion is 0.1 decimal. Number of individuals, it is found that none of them are blue. So, number of individuals is 0. The sample size is 33. Level of significance is 0.01 in decimal. Calculate. So the p-value is 0.0618 is the p-value. 0.0618. Conclusion: do not reject the null hypothesis. There is not sufficient evidence to warrant the rejection of the null hypothesis. Fail to reject the null hypothesis. There is insufficient evidence to warrant the rejection of the claim. That's to warrant the rejection of the null, which is the claim that the proportion of candies that are blue is equal to 0.10. Okay. Question 21. A candy company makes 5 different colors of candies. Find a sample proportion of candies that are green. Use that result to test the claim that 15% of the company's candies are green. Use the data in the table below, the p-value method, and a significance level of 5%. Okay, we want to find the sample proportion of candies that are green. So, folks, we're gonna use StatCrunch in this case. We use StatCrunch here, okay? We're gonna use StatCrunch here. So I'm gonna do this. We'll click on this, open this in StatCrunch. Open in StatCrunch. Sample proportion of candies. Proportion of candies that are green. So sample proportion of green candies. All right. Let's find first the whole. Let's find the sample size of. This is 16 plus. You know what? We can go ahead and add it. We have 16 red plus 22 blue plus 17 brown plus 15 green plus 15 yellow. So 85, okay? Then the green, we have 15 green. So the sample proportion is 15 divided by 85. And that gives us, you know what? Let's, I'm just gonna use 15 out of 85. So I will use proportion stats, one sample. You know what, folks? We did success would be just be the green. Yeah, I'm trying to use one sample with data. Okay, so look at what we can do, folks. I'm gonna do this first with summary, and I'll do it with data. Okay, should give us the same thing. Okay, we have 15 green candies out of 85 candies. So stats, proportion stats, one sample with summary. Let's do summary first. We have 15, we have 85. Hypothesis test is, we want 15%. Test the claim that 15% of the company's candies are green. So this is a two-tailed test. Okay, it's a two-tailed. I'm gonna go ahead and put it two-tailed. So, come back here. Bring this up. This is 0.15. It's two-tailed. Let's store it in table. Store it in data table. Let's store it in data table. Compute. So we have this now in the data table. Yeah. We have it in the data table. Sample proportion. Okay. Then let's do this again. I'm gonna close this. Then I'm gonna do this with data. Proportion stats, one sample with data. Values are in green. Right? Anyway, let me select the whole thing. Let's select the whole thing here. Actually, we want the total, the count. Actually, not the, we want just the count. Okay? Values are in count. And the success is 15. 0.15. And then we do compute. Let's check whether we got the same thing. No. Sample proportion. The count is one. No. Start. Proportion starts one sample with data. Let's put all this as the values. And then success is 15. This 0.15. You see, I'm trying to learn something as I'm doing this video as well. Compute. Okay. Folks, just you see what I did? I counted it. Just use one sample with summary, okay? One sample with summary. Test statistic is our Z stat. That's our Z stat, and that is 0.68. 0.68. P value is 0.494. This is three decimal places. 0.494. This is greater than the significance level, so fail to reject the null because the p value is greater than the significance level. And when you do that, there is insufficient evidence to warrant the rejection of the null. Fail to reject the null because there is insufficient evidence to warrant the rejection of the null. But here you see there is not sufficient evidence to warrant rejection of the claim that the 15% are green. Yeah, there is insufficient evidence to warrant rejection of that null. Okay. Question 22. Consider a flight to be on time if it arrives no later than 15 minutes after the scheduled arrival time. Negative arrival times correspond to flights arriving earlier than their scheduled arrival time. Use the sample data to test the claim that 79.1% of flights are on time. Use a 1% significance level and the p-value method to answer the following questions. So, here is going to be a two-tail test. To say two-tail test. Two-tail test. And the flight arrives on time if it's no later than 15 minutes. So let's open this icon. Let's close this first. Okay. Then we open this, click here, open in StatCrunch. So the flight is on time. Let me close this here. The flight is on time if it arrives no later than 15 minutes. So less than 15 minutes. Okay, and negative arrival times is also early. Arriving earlier than their scheduled arrival time. So this is what I'm gonna do here. Instead of counting all these, let me sort them. Let me sort this. I can name this as times, arrival times, arrival times. I can name the variable as arrival times. If you want to, you must not, okay? I want to sort this. I want to sort it and put it here. I want to sort it and put it in another column. So it will be easy for me to count. So let me sort this in ascending order. I'm going to go to data. I'll go to sort. I select the variable. Okay. Sort in ascending. Sort arrival times. Oh, this is an optional. No. Just sort direction. Sort direction ascending order. Compute. So I've sorted it now here. And then I count how many of them are less than 15. Because I want to find the number of individuals. The sample size is 40. And how many of them are less than 15 is 35. 35 of them are less than 15. So go to start, proportion stats, one sample with summary. 15 successes and 40 observations. Let's check it again to make sure. Sorry, 35 successes. Ah, yeah, 35 successes in 40 observations. So, start, proportion stats, one sample with summary. 35 successes, 40 observations, and the population proportion is 0.791. And this is a two-tailed test, so you leave it like that. And just compute. So Z stat is 1.31. 1.31. P-value is 0.1913. P-value is greater than the significance level. So fail to reject the null because the p-value is greater than the significance level. There is insufficient evidence to warrant rejection of the claim that these are on time. Okay. There is insufficient evidence to warrant rejection of the null. Okay. We've been solving calculations. Which of the following is not a requirement of testing a claim about a population proportion using a formal method of hypothesis testing? The lowercase symbol p represents the probability of getting a test statistic at least as extreme as the one representing sample data and is needed to test the claim. This is not a requirement. Question 24. Which of the following is not true when testing a claim about a proportion? So please take some time and read it. It's not true when testing a claim about a proportion. A, when testing claims about population proportions, the traditional method, which is the classical method, and the p-value method are equivalent in the sense that they always yield the same result. That is correct. It's true. B, a conclusion based on a confidence interval estimate will be the same as a conclusion based on a hypothesis test. C, both the traditional method and the p-value method use the same standard deviation based on the claimed proportion p, but the confidence interval uses an estimated standard deviation based on the sample proportion p hat. Okay, that's true. D, if you want to test a claim about population proportions, use the p-value method or the classical method of hypothesis testing. That's true. Testing a claim about a population, I know from your textbook, your textbook will go with this. B, a conclusion based on a confidence interval estimate will be the same as a conclusion based on a hypothesis testing. Now, From your textbook, you know, this will be the option here from your textbook. You know, it says that it's not always true that a conclusion based on confidence interval estimate will be the same as a conclusion based on a hypothesis test. A good strategy is to use a confidence interval to estimate a population proportion, but use the p-value method or traditional method for testing a claim about a proportion. And that is correct. You know, we use confidence interval method when we want to estimate, like, you know, like we did in chapter 7, estimating population parameters. It's not always true. Sometimes it's true, sometimes it might not be. For the most part, for the calculations I've always done, it's been true. It's been the same conclusion. However, you know, I want you to learn the three methods regardless. I want you to learn the three methods. The main methods, of course, are the p-value method and the classical method. But I still want you to learn it with the confidence interval method for two tail tests. Question 25. Which of the following is not true of using the binomial probability distribution to test claims about a proportion? In a right tail test, the p-value is the probability of getting X or more successes among the N trials. That's right. This method uses the binomial probability distribution with the p-value method and uses the value of the population proportion assumed in the null hypothesis. That's right. One requirement of this method is that there will be NP is greater than 5 and NQ is greater than 5. That's not true. D, in a left tail test, the p-value is the probability of getting X or fewer successes among N trials. So I'm going to go with C. Okay, these are not requirements of using the binomial probability distribution to test claims about a proportion. All right, thank you so much for listening. Just save this. Thank you so much for listening to this video session. If you have any questions, please ask. Watch out for further videos, and you have a great day.